All right, moving on. So the applicable provisions we already saw on HTS US. We noted that warranty is required for Canada, and it is not required for Mexico. All right. Now we get to the interesting stuff. So we get to the valuation requirements. So valuation under NAFTA. And we saw that when we were looking at the general law 12T, where you have to have where substantial transformation is given, not only provided that the change in heading, in other words, there is a tariff shift, but there is also valuation requirement. And valuation requirement, sometimes they do, sometimes they do not, but they may give you the choice, and the choice is between the net cost and the transaction value method. So for those folks who are not familiar with the concept of transaction value, please visit or review the lecture on valuation and appraisement of merchandise, because the concept of transaction value is another term of art. It is very fact driven, a lot of deductions, additions, subtractions that are part or not part of the transaction value. In giving this lecture, I assume that we are familiar with the concept of transaction value already. Here, what we already saw in the general note 12 is the fact that we do have those formulas given, and this is the paragraph C of the general note 12. It kind of defines. What is it kind of defines the concept of regional value content, and regional value content we saw can be provided. The numbers are provided like 60% or 50% of the regional value content. Those are derived by applying this formula. So either or, right? So in here, so the transaction value method would be RVC, regional value content, would be transaction value minus no value of non-originating materials divided by transaction value and then multiplied by 100. Here, regional value content under the net cost method is calculated. You go to the net cost of the product. You subtract the value of non-originating materials. Then again, you divide. So it's very similar. You divide by net cost, just like you divide by transaction value here. And of course, to get the percentages straight, you multiply this stuff by 100. Please do not mess up on order of operations. It's very important. They use parentheses to show, but first subtract this from this, then divide it by this, and then multiply by 100, all right? If you mess up the order of operations, you'll get your numbers incorrectly, and that can get you in trouble. So again, I assume that everyone is familiar with order of operations, so I'm not going to give a lecture on mathematics, and I assume that we're familiar with this stuff. All right, now, given the formulas, now let's talk about the definition. So original value content, of course, is a concept which is usually described in percentages, and you have to find out, because to qualify for NAFTA, provided the tariff shifting, you have to have certain part of the good that is local, right? That is local. We already saw in a way the the regional value content requirement in the GSP and Israel and Jordan free trade agreements, where you have to have that 35% threshold of domestic material, right? The difference between the GSP, Jordan, and Israel free trade agreements is that they do not require you to engage in this formula. They kind of say, all right, take the whole number and do the calculation that way. This one is a little bit more elaborate. So we're going to have to fit the numbers into this formula. Transaction value, of course, is the transaction value of a good, and I'm not going to dive into the transaction value concept too heavily, except we see this adjusted on FOB basis. So transaction value usually is a price. I'm going to just be brief about transaction. Transaction value is a price paid or payable, right? So whatever you pay, if you go to the store, you see that the price for this marker is $2.99. So you pull out your $2.99 and you pay it to the clerk. So it's the same concept. Whatever is asked, that is given. That's transaction value. The net cost, on the other hand, is something which is used without transaction value. So it's the cost of inputs that you put into the product itself that make up. You add up the various labor costs, you add up the parts, the supplies, the raw materials, and you get with the net cost of what it cost, what was the cost to produce the product. With the concept of transaction value being adjusted on FOB basis, this concept is very well provided for or defined for in the appendix of the 181, part 181. So here it is, adjusted on FOB basis. So it pretty much means deducting or adding the cost of transporting the good from the point of direct shipment, unloading, packing, and hereby adding if they are included or if they are not included. Simply said, like, think about this. If you have a cost, so let's say cost of unloading, loading, right? So if the transaction value is X and you include cost of unloading, let's call it Y, which is a cost of unloading, right? Here you have also X, but you are not including into the cost the loading or unloading, right? So that would be the price for this one, that would be the price for this one. So simply said here, in this case you have to deduct Y, and in this case you have to add Y to make an adjustment, right? For FOB. And of course FOB would be like FOB Shanghai, right? Or FOB Guadalajara. Because freight on board means usually means under the international commercial terms, also abbreviated as INCO terms, it gets the responsibility, the cost included. So let's say you have FOB Tijuana, right? So the buyer would be responsible to get it to the Tijuana border, and the seller, so this is responsibility of the seller, I'm sorry, not the buyer, seller, and this becomes the responsibility of the buyer once it hits the border. And of course usually I shouldn't say Tijuana, because FOB usually deals with the ocean shipment. So let's call it Cabo San Lucas. All right, a port town in Mexico, right? So FOB Cabo San Lucas. Responsibility of the seller ends once it crosses the rail of the ship once it gets onto the ship to sail to the United States. So that's the pretty much the concept of FOB. Direct shipment is also defined because point of direct shipment is kind of tricky concept. What's the point of direct shipment, right? We kind of understand that direct shipment would be the port of not Tijuana, let's say, but port of Cabo San Lucas. Definitions in the appendix, part 181 appendix, also do a fine job of defining the point of direct shipment. It means the location from which a producer of a good normally ship the goods to the delivery to the buyer of the good. All right. So that's for the adjustments. Back to the outline. All right. So that's the transaction value. It's adjusted on an FOB basis. And value of non-originating material, of course, it is that value of non-originating material which do not come from that NAFTA country, right? It's the stuff which are non-Mexican, it's the stuff that are non-Canadian, it's the stuff that are not United States, do not originate from United States. On the net cost side, notice that net cost, while it includes all those stuff, it excludes sales, promotions, royalties, shipping, and packing. So in other words, marketing stuff, royalties, and shipping and receiving is not part of the net cost calculation. It is more goes into the production process, not into the distribution channels of the product. So we have an example here where we have boots. And those boots come from South Africa. And South Africa, of course, is a non-NAFTA country. It is a GSP country, but it's not a NAFTA country. So whenever you deal with the free trade agreements, please keep in mind that there is such a breakdown. Now, those boots are made out of leather. And other non-leather material are classifiable in this HTS-US. And the HTS-US itself, is in chapter 64. So, that's the HTS-US for the whole boot. So boots are HTS-US. Boots are classified under 64, 03, 51, 30. The leather itself, if you go into the classification of the leather, which is seems like to me the only non-originating material, looking at the cost breakdown, is classified in a different heading, right? It's classifiable under 410719. If you want a shortcut, go to the alphabetical index. I just kind of looked at that before. It may be somewhere else, but this is a good approximation. The point here is that there is a tariff shift, right, which takes place in Mexico. All right. So, what's the question here? The question here is there a substantial transformation for the boots? So, if we take a look at the general note 12 for the chapter 64, it says that there must be a change to heading 6104 through 6405, 6401 through 6405, from any other heading of the good, right? Except for that one, 4107, so it is in chapter 41, or actually the heading 4107 is outside of this group, so we're good on the tariff shift. That's the first step. The second step is 55% for the net cost. So we're not given a transaction a choice to go to the transaction value. We are given the only choice, which is the net cost value, and we must stick to this formula. So what we do is we need to figure out, based on these numbers, is this 55% or not 55 or more, or 55% or less, or is it more? If it's 55 or less, then we're good. If it's more, then we're not so good. All right, so we go to the, we plug in those numbers into this formula, right? So recall that 1269 is the cost of that leather. That's the labor cost, I believe, if we go in. So 1414 or other materials which are originating, right? Labor cost over here, 40 cents is a factory overhead. And then we have a total FOB price, which is $69. Now, since it's a net cost value, we are not really concerned that much with the 69. We are concerned with all this stuff because we're going to plug them in. So the net cost itself is comprised of all this stuff. It's not the FOB price. It's comprised of all these items that go into the production. So as you can see, if you add them up, that's the net cost. It will be 28.34 per set of boots. But when figuring out value of known, value of non-originating material here, it's the South African leather, which is 1269. So see, it is part of the net cost, and it is also a separate line item in the formula. So we have the net cost now, 28.34. We have the value of non-originating material, which is really the only South African stuff, the South African leather, 1269. So we're ready to plug it in. And if you plug it in, it comes out to $55. 55.22 percentage wise. So 55.22, and we have a requirement 55% of the net cost or less. Since it is not less than 55%. So since it is not less than 55%, you have the meeting just by 22 hundredths of percentage points. So that's kind of like almost on the borderline there. But it fits the criteria because all you need is 55 even. So even if you had a zero over here, you would still meet the criteria. So you have that minimum threshold met, and therefore you can claim NAFTA preferential treatment.